Vi står her til Odense Filmfestival 2020, og lige nu der er vi ved åbningsceremoniet ved Den Røde Løber og venter på alle de kreative filmskabere.
Jeg synes, at det er et utroligt spændende format, fordi der bliver fortalt historien, der bliver anderledes historier, der bliver fortalt, og de bliver fortalt på en anderledes måde. Man kommer meget hurtigt til sagen, der er ikke en masse sådan indledende øvelser, du skal til. Men du kan gå ind midt i en scene, eller midt i en relation, eller midt i et møde med et menneske. Og jeg sidder i dokumentarjuryen, så det er jo altså nogle virkelige historier.
Ja, det er så.
Ja, så det er ret barske sager, vil jeg sige.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host of the evening, Birgitte Weinberger.
Good evening! Good evening! Your Royal Highness, patron of this festival, Minister of Culture, ambassadors, film lovers and filmmakers, volunteers, from all over. Dear guest, a warm, warm welcome to the opening of Denmark's International Oscar Qualifying Short Film Festival of 20! My name is Birgitte, and I'm the festival director and head of program here at OFF, and I'll be your host tonight. And it's with great pleasure that I will present to you this year's festival and guide you through an evening with speeches and, of course, some great short films. OFF started in the year 1975 and is the oldest film festival in Denmark. And this year, we celebrate 45 years of short films and love in Odense. A lot has happened since 75, but the core is still the same. Fantastic, strange, imaginative, thought-provoking and touching short films from all over. Talks, panels, concerts and so much more. And this year, it's no exception. Even though many things have been turned upside down by the ongoing global pandemic, which has indeed caused quite a few changes, cancellations and extraordinary precautions. Og ja, det vil helt sikkert have været lettere at aflyse og vente på bedre tider til næste år. Men vi har faktisk kæmpet en ret hård kamp for at finde en vej, fordi vi synes, at det er vigtigt. Særligt i år, særligt i en krisetid, hvor verden lukker sig om sig selv, og utryghed og angst sætter ind. Der bliver vi nødt til at arbejde for at komme hinanden ved og mødes på tværs i kunsten. Og derfor er jeg så enormt stolt og taknemmelig på festivalens vegne over, at vi har fået OFF 20 på vingerne. Og hvis vi alle sammen holder afstand, hænderne rene, hovedet koldt og hjertet varmt, så skal det nok gå det hele. Og derfor bliver Off heller ikke den fysiske fest, som vi kender. Men vi har forsøgt at skabe. Vi har forsøgt at skabe alt det, vi kan, og så må krammerne vente til næste år. Og lad mig da også opfordre til, at vi møder hinanden med lidt fysisk afstand. Og I kan allerede nu blive indviet i den officielle Off-hilsen. Den ser nemlig sådan her ud. Wow! Skulle vi lige se om med... Kan I? Nej! Wonderful! Sådan. Mine damer og herrer, it's my great pleasure to present the first speaker of this night, the official host of the festival, Mayor of Culture and Urban Development in Odense, Jane Jegin!
Your Royal Highness, Minister of Culture, dear ambassadors, dear filmmakers, dear volunteers and dear guests, I'm so happy to welcome all of you to the 45th annual Off Odense International Film Festival. Odense International Film Festival is one of the cornerstone in Odense's cultural life, and I'm both proud and relieved to be able to stand here and welcome you all to a week of amazing short films. It shows a great deal of courage and tells the tale of an unbendable will to keep contributing to the cultural life in Odense, despite many obstacles, for 45 years, ladies and gentlemen. Since the world changed in early spring, we have all felt the lack of sharing and experiencing new, thrilling things together. Debating the play, or the movie we just watched, or the concert we just sang our way through. In my mind, it is very clear that culture is a very big part of who we are, who we aspire to be, and a place to kindle our dreams. Politically, we discuss whether culture is welfare, and so far as it helps us understand who we are, relieves loneliness, and aids balanced coexistence across differences, culture is much more than just welfare. Culture is identity. Imagine what our world our life would be like without music, film, books, theater, art in general. What a lonely and pointless place. So thank God for Off 20. Thanks for the short film format, and thanks for the fact that we are now able to enjoy at least a snippet of these happy times together, be it under somewhat different conditions than prior years. During the past 6 months, one thing has become quite clear to me. When the world around us shuts down, we need more than anything to explore it. That specific exploring starts here today at Off 20. The festival has created an online possibility for all of us to enjoy, and especially for those who are at risk. But through the magic of this year's selected films, the opportunity now exists to go off-stream and explore the unknown, just as well as you, honored guests, will be doing during this week right here in Odense. The festival is taking every precaution to keep safe and follow the guidelines appointed by the government. Please take care of yourself and each other. I know you will. To this year's program and the off-stream opportunity, we can travel to the unknown while being safe, armed only with open minds and a lot of hand sanitizer. We need to educate our minds and hearts, and the safest and most thrilling way to do that is to the accuracy, excitement, and enchantment that Off 20 can offer us. Take a seat and feel yourself get smarter, stronger, learn about the world that for now is beyond our limits. And let me send a warm thank to all the festival's volunteers sitting nearby watching on a screen. I would just like to say that none of this could be done without you. Thank you. And thank you so much to Your Royal Highness for gracing us with your presence. It means a lot. Thank you to all the sponsors. Thank you to the Minister of Culture, and thank you to all the ambassadors. Thank you for making sure that week 35 in Odense once again is a celebration of short films from all over the world. So, dear guests, I now have the honor to declare off 20 Odense International Film Festival open. Thank you.
Jette Jikki, mine damer og herrer. Tusind tak til Jette Jikki. Tak til Odense Kommune. Mange af jer ved det godt, for Fyn er fin, men Fyn er også film. Fyn er film hele året rundt, båret af stærke samarbejder mellem de mange filmaktører på Fyn. Det er et samarbejde, der skaber synergi og vækst, og som vi sætter utrolig stor pris på. Den store verden har dog også fået øje på Fyn, og det kan vi mærke her på Aarhus, en markant interesse, når det handler om at tilmelde sin film til konkurrencen. I år har vi modtaget lige knap 3.000 kortfilm. Det er sådan, man er rigtig glad for, at det er kortfilm, vi arbejder med. Fra over 100 forskellige lande. Og sidste år havde vi faktisk besøg af over 30.000 gæster under Aarhus-ugen, og omkring 35.000, hvis vi tæller det hele med, når vi besøger andre events ude omkring i landet. De tal, dem kan vi naturligvis ikke matche i år. Men til gengæld, så findes vi. Og udover at vi findes i den fysiske verden, så præsenterer vi også i år nogle helt coronavenlige tiltag, som du, Jane, lige har været inde på. Blandt andet netop denne offstream, som både indeholder titler fra tidligere år, men som også fra i dag screener de konkurrencefilm, som vi viser på festivalen her. De ligger altså nu online, så der er ingen undskyldning længere for ikke at være til off, uanset geografi eller sundhedstilstand. Så har vi også søsat en filmpodcast, der kort og godt hedder Kort er godt, hvor jeg sammen med skuespiller Claus Riis Østergaard taler om vores fælles passion, som sjovt nok er kortfilm. I det korte format, ja. For kort er godt. Og selvom vi nu både har en streaming og en podcast oven i alt det andet, vi laver, så er vi slet ikke færdige endnu. Off er på mange måder i verdensklasse, men der er fortsat et kæmpe potentiale. Og det erklærede mål er at blive hele Danmarks filmfestival og den førende i Europa. Det gør vi ved at bygge videre på det, vi har. Et fyrtårn med format og kvalitet på alle hylder. Og nu vil jeg gerne give ordet til en samarbejdspartner, der har været med os fra tidernes morgen. Det er det Danske Filminstitut, der med deres støtte har givet Danmarks Internationale Kortfilmsfestival mulighed for ikke bare at overleve, men at vokse sig større og stærkere. Og det er vi mega glade for. Mine damer og herrer, tag rigtig godt imod Jakob Neidenholm fra det Danske Filminstitut!
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm very happy to be here, despite DSB's attempt to prove otherwise. Your Royal Highness, Minister of Culture, Ambassadors, on behalf of the Danish Film Institute, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to this opening of the 2020 edition of the Odense Film Festival. Make no mistake, this is a hugely important event, not just for us at the Danish Film Institute, for the industry, for the audience, but perhaps most importantly for the talents, the new talents who are responsible for keeping the art of filmmaking alive and vibrant. Film is the most powerful art form we have, but it's too often taken for granted just because it's so easy to access, so easy to consume for audiences of all ages. Yet that's exactly why we need to focus on our filmmaking community and support it. As a creative country, we need to stay ahead of the curve. We need to stay focused on building and preserving our position as one of the most important filmmaking countries in the world. The amount of films of all lengths, from the long-running TV series to the latest TikTok craze, all fight for our attention. But it has never been harder to know which films deserve our attention. But that's why we need curators more than ever. And as such, we cannot ask for a better guide than this festival. So without further ado, I want to encourage you to bring your curiosity to the cinema, to open your eyes and your minds to this year's program. And now, I leave you with the, let's call her, uncrowned queen of Danish cinema history, Gita Nørby, in Mads Kodal's Between a Rock and a Hard Place. Thank you very much.
Så den, men den der, så skal du sådan, det er jo godt. Har du en anden kind også? Den var god. Så er den. Nu er du lige så fin som ny. Nu er jeg så fin som ny.
Hvert år udpeger Off en kunstnerisk profil, der får mulighed for at sætte sit aftryk på et lille hjørne af festivalen med en række arrangementer, som profilen er afsender på og medvirker i. Sidste år var det skuespiller og instruktør Marianne Jankovic, der overtog stafetten fra den alternative filmuddannelse Super 16, og hun lavede et fantastisk program om mod. Mod til at være den, man er. Stå ved, hvad man kommer af og hvor man kommer fra. Marianne kommer fra Montenegro. Dette års profil kommer fra Nyborg. Og han er intet mindre end en verdensstjerne. Årets kunstneriske profil er en af dansk films mest velrenommerede lyddesignere og har arbejdet på en lang række spillefilm, dokumentarfilm, tv-serier og selvfølgelig kortfilm. Både danske og internationale, og han har vundet adskillige priser og senest været nomineret til en Oscar med filmen The Cave. Men hvor starter sådan en gloværdig karriere, mon dog? På Off, selvfølgelig. Årets kunstneriske profil deltog nemlig helt tilbage i 91 på Offs tegnefilmsworkshop. Ja, ja. Det ville nok være sådan lidt af en tilsnigelse at tage æren for noget som helst. Men stoltheden, den er stor. Og respekten, den er dybfølt. Mine damer og herrer, tag godt imod årets kunstneriske profil, Peter Albrechtsen!
Thank you. Amazing. The sound is good, right? This is really, really overwhelming, and I want to say thank you to the festival for doing this. It's really incredible. It's amazing to have you people here. It's amazing to have Royal Company tonight, Cultural Minister. It's because movies are very important, and movies are very important for all of us. And for me, I often get asked about, okay, what is the sound thing? What is you doing, Peter? And the people then usually ask me, and now I know you're doing the music for the film. And then I'm saying, no, I'm not doing the music. Then they say, you're the one recording the actor's voice with that microphone. And I'm saying, no, I'm actually not doing that. Now I know you're the guy who makes sure that we cannot hear what the actors are saying on TV. And there's maybe a little bit of that. Making sound for movies is something I've done for 20 years now, and it's still an adventure. It's still amazing how it just keeps on like becoming something new. Every day that I go to work is like being on a playground, being creative, trying to make poetry. I'm very happy for this artistic profile, because for me that is really what we do. Everyone on a film team creates art. The other day I had my son and his good friend. He's 10 years old. He started making movies now, of course. And then he brought his friend to the studio, and they had made some films on their cell phones, and I was helping them making sounds for that. And when I was sitting there creating some sounds for their movies, then the friend, he was like, he got so excited and he laughed so much that he fell down the chair. And then he said, "Is this really what you do for a living?" And yes, this is what I do for a living. I create the sonic worlds for the movies I do. And it's really amazing how sound talks to the subconscious and has this amazing poetic power. Tonight I brought a British short film that I mixed 5-6 years ago. It's called Notes on Blindness. And I think for my message to this festival would really be to be very aware of your senses. That's why my program this year is called Sensuous. It's really about being aware of your senses and listen. And this film is really about the senses. Thank you for inviting me. Thank you, everybody.
After nearly 3 years of blindness, I find that the pictures in the gallery of my mind have dimmed somewhat. So I found with great distress that I could no longer remember easily what my wife looked like or what my daughter Imogen looked like. It's beautiful to know.
Tak til dig, Peter. Tak, fordi du sagde ja til opgaven. Det har ikke været let, og rammerne for dit arbejde har konstant forandret sig. Og det endte med at blive en lidt anden opgave, end den du sagde ja til. Men du har været fantastisk at arbejde sammen med, og vi glæder os vildt til en sanselig uge sammen med dig. Rigtig god festival. Og udover den kunstneriske profils lange række af spændende programmer, så har vi en lang række andre programmer. Og kernen, det bankende hjerte i festivalen her, det er jo de mange fantastiske kortfilm fra hele verden, som deltager i vores konkurrence. 2.945 kortfilm lå på vores bord ved deadline 1. april. Og et svært selektionsarbejde gik i gang for at finde de film, der lige præcis er off 20. Det endelige udvalg på 129 film fra 42 lande skal i ugens løb dyste om vores priser, statuetter, diplomer og 4 genveje til Oscar-akademiets bedømmelse, og størst af alt naturligvis æren. De skal fordeles af vores kompetente juryer, som I skal møde om lidt. Men for at give jer en fornemmelse af den vidstrakte mangfoldighed i udtryksformer og stemninger, historier og verdener, vi præsenterer, skal vi nu se alle 129 film. I har drømt om det, har I? Alt andet er aflyst, I kan lige så godt bare blive. Vi har lavet et lille sammenklip på bare 6 minutter, som tager med på en vild rejse. Den kommer her. Thank you so much to the incredible filmmakers! Short films have so many great qualities. They're able to move us, provoke us, excite us. They can strike up a conversation, open your mind, encourage human encounters. And what's most important to all is actually that. To connect people, combining different parts of the world through these intense stories. We wish more than anything to be a hub for contemplation, reflection, in solitude, or in the company of others. But OFF is also a competition. On Saturday, our juries will not only award Oscar-qualifying prizes, they will also select a shortlisted candidate among the long-listed European short films in the competition. This film will go to compete for a place among the nominees in the short film category at the European Film Awards. Yeah. And OFF is also the place where the Danish Film Academy find and announce the 5 nominees for their Robert Award. Robert Award. Well, all right. So, stakes are high, ladies and gentlemen. Shouldn't we meet the juries? Yes, we should.
In the main competition jury, please welcome animation film director Amalie Nesby Fick, graduated from the Danish Film School in 2016. Her graduation film Stripes won the Audience Award at ORF 16. Head of festivals, actor, producer and director from Syria, Mazen Haj Kasim. Mazen is the festival manager and founder of the film festival Syriske Dage, which introduced its audience to Syrian culture for the past 2 years. Producer Morten Kaufmann produced a large number of award-winning films, including Jagten, which won an award at Cannes Film Festival and was nominated for an Oscar. 65 films from 42 countries have been selected for this year's main competition. In the Danish competition jury, please welcome Head of Berlinale Shorts, Anna Henkel Donnersmark. Programmer, moderator, and member of the jury for film festivals for more than 20 years. Actor Rasmus Botoft. Previously a part of the ensemble at the Royal Danish Theatre and appeared in a number of films and TV series, including Lykke and Arvingerne. Director and photographer Sun-Hee Engelstoft. Directed the documentary Forget Me Not, which was nominated for a Bodil Award and a Robert Award for Best Documentary. 30 Danish shorts are selected for this year's competition. In the animation competition jury, please welcome producer Charlotte de la Chonnerie, currently producing several major animated projects and shares her experience in production and crowdfunding in talks and lectures around Europe. Director Johan Oettinger directed 7 minutes in the Warsaw Ghetto, shown at more than 120 different festivals across the world and received several awards. Director, producer, scriptwriter and actor Michael Vigge created legendary works such as Hannibal og Jerry and Flyvende Farmor, receiver of the honorary award at the Bodil Awards earlier this year. The animation competition presents 37 short films and is held in cooperation with Anis We Animate. In the documentary competition, please welcome sound artist, filmmaker, composer and sound designer Anne Gry Friis Christensen. Received 2 Robert nominations for Best Score and Best Sound Designer for her work on the feature film Harpix. Actress Ellen Hillingsø starred in many TV series, movies and theater productions, including the feature film Sekten, for which she received a Robert Award for Best Female in a Supporting Role. Director Mathias Brue, educated from Super 16 and won Pitch Me Baby at ORF 17 with his project Amphi, which went on to win a Robert Award for Best Documentary Short in early 2020. The documentary competition features 30 short films. We are so proud of our youth jury this year. Selected students from 9. A Munkebjergskolen in Odense, Liva, Didan, Sine, Trung, Katrine, Mirmaya and Mille. The selection of short films in the youth competition consists of 20 films suited for young audiences age 14 and up.